This is the Macbeth Body Biography by Nathan Amelie and Quinlan.
Hell is murky. Lady Macbeth says this line, which insinuates that she's seen hell because she seems to know what it looks like. This quote was said by Lady Macbeth. Number two. How does he feel his title hang loose above him, like a giant's robe upon a dwarfish thief? The title of a king that Macbeth holds does not fit him because of the way he's reached that title. Figuratively, his king robes do not fit him and never will. Number three, angels are bright still, though the brightest fell. The devil was once the brightest angel. Macbeth used to be this brave and honest man. And as he stood out among the others that fought with him. Yet now he's being compared to the devil, which is the relentless hunger for power. Number four, to be thus is nothing, but to be safely thus. Macbeth says how he isn't capable to be king, yet Macbeth sends murderers after Banquo and his son so he can be able to keep the throne to only himself. This role of king is becoming useless to him because he's unable to secure it. To be secure in it.
The background. Macbeth is above all those he has killed and above the forest while he's reaching up to the heavens. The nature below is rebelling because it shows all the destruction he has caused to get to his status. Examples of this rebelling nature are unnatural-looking trees and horses eating horses. He is falling into this hell he has created for himself, which shows that he has to face the consequences of his relentless murders. The three apparitions hover above him to show to what point they control him. Macbeth is fully relying on these prophecies to keep him safe. Therefore, these hallucinations hold higher power over him. The feat. Macbeth is falling to show that his life is no longer stable. By the end of the play, he has nothing left of value to him. His position as king is being overthrown, his wife is dead, and no one supports him anymore. He is falling into the hell below to show that all his actions have finally reached him and he has to face the consequences. The foundation of his initial character is no longer present.
This is Macbeth. The heart. Lady Macbeth is what Macbeth looks forward to and who he loves. She seemed to motivate, and because they have a relationship, they both trust each other and push each other. Lady Macbeth is seen holding Macbeth's heart, and her hands with red polish will strangle the heart. This is because the love in the relationship is seen that the two have loyalty and trust. However, it is seen that she uses standards and norms to manipulate and encourage Macbeth to kill the king so he becomes the ruler of Scotland. Lady Macbeth is holding Macbeth's heart to show that she was the first push towards this search for security and power. In the first two acts, she is the motivating force that makes Macbeth kill Duncan, the king. Therefore, she holds his heart to show that she was had control over him when he is deciding whether or not to go down to the dark path of becoming a king. The Bible represents the Holy Grail as something that is unattainable by anyone. Something that was never achieved that Macbeth desired was the view that he's seen by himself as higher. This is as a result of his power. The power forced him to feel like he was above all. The king, hence, is seen to have connections with God. Macbeth took advantage of that and became valiant. As he hid behind walls and secretly killed families. When Macbeth is hidden behind everybody and everything around him, he is unable to shape into someone who is able to control a country. Changes. The shadow will show the difference between who he is now and who he used to be. The shadow is Macbeth in armor, which shows that his main priority used to be a great and successful soldier. He killed in the field out of duty. Now he's drawn and falling because he no longer has any moral ground to stand on. He lost the man that he used to be.
Vices and virtues. Macbeth's main virtue is ambition, yet it is also his downfall. At the beginning, this quality is used in order to motivate him in war. But near the end, his ambition is causing him to be power hungry. This need for power leads him to kill innocent families and turns him into a paranoid, tyrant-like king. This is represented by the bodies on the ground. The families and friends were the sacrifice to give Macbeth this higher power he craved, yet could never fully reach.